Call of Duty finally got revealed, a new Prince of Persia leaks emerges once more, and play the new Batman game without Batman? Hello everybody and welcome to a brand new episode of Top Gaming News, and before we go right into it, make sure to hit that like button and also comment down below as the video goes on. Finally, Call of Duty has revealed that the next game is going to be called Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War, with a new teaser and a worldwide reveal will happen this very Wednesday. The teaser looks back at the story of the real-life Soviet defector Yuri Bezmenov, whose interview we saw in the teaser, where he talks about the Soviet strategy of Western dominance through a process of demoralization, destabilization, crisis, and normalization. Treyarch also released a art for the game, which is super colorful that we have never seen ever before. On the left we have the Soviet and on the right we have the Americans. As I said, this is a new poster that we have seen from a Black Ops game. Usually there's a guy sitting as a Black Ops poster, so it's a good thing that we actually have more than one guy in the poster. Over the weeks, Call of Duty has been teased around, from the pack of Doritos to influencers getting a crate of Call of Duty. And now finally the game has made a reveal, and I cannot wait to see how the game looks this Wednesday. Hopefully they use the same engine that they have used for Modern Warfare, because to be honest, that engine looks amazing. When the influencers got the crate, they also ended up with a website called PawnTakesPawn.com, which also shows a video showing the tension between US and Soviet. Also, this isn't the first time we saw Kennedy in a video game, because we also saw Kennedy in Black Ops. He was a bit different and he was very into zombies, but he was there. And it looks like this game will also have more of Kennedy. Who knows? What do you guys think of the new Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War? I mean, there's nothing to say because it was all real footage and we have not seen any gameplay, but are you guys excited to see the Black Ops reveal? Because I am, and I hope it's not the same as the previous game. I hope it's something better and it's something new. And I do not want numbers again. God damn it, Mason. Please, stop. Crysis Remaster came with a new release date of September 18th, and it's also having a new trailer. The only downside is the game is coming exclusive on Epic Store, which doesn't make sense because isn't Crysis a EA game? The remaster was supposed to release on July, but since the trailer got leaked and everybody was unhappy how the game was looking, a lot of people said that the game was exactly looking the same, and some people also said that the game is looking worse than the original game, which I think was true. Now it looks like Crytek worked on the visual aspects of the game to make sure that everybody's happy, and they showed a new tech trailer for Crysis, showing the visual changes between the original game and the remaster version of the game, and to be honest, it does look good. Although they did not show the suit, which is something that I want to see, and also the characters, so I really want to see how they look. But to be honest, one thing that drew me in was the sand, because that looks pretty cool. I don't know why I got drawn into that, but it still looks cool. All I can hope that since it's a remaster, I hope that the visual aspects of the game has actually changed, because we have seen some snippets of it. We haven't seen everything that the game has. Also, I do hope that the gameplay is same as the original one. I mean, I hope they don't change any of that, because to be honest, in my opinion, the Crysis gameplay was much more smoother and simpler in comparison to other Crysis games. Speaking of a new game, Black Myth Wukong, a new project from a Chinese studio, GameSign Studio, showed a 13-minute gameplay of an early build of the game, and my god, the game looks really amazing. The combat feels amazing, the game looks gorgeous, and you can change shapes. I mean, you can grow from small bug to a human-sized person to a monster-sized person. That's incredible. And overall, the early build of the game, that itself looks absolutely solid. The game is based on popular Chinese novel Journey to the West from the 16th century, and it looks like it was adapted in other games as well, but now GameSign Studios are making a serious adaptation of this where you control Sam Wukong, the Monkey King himself. I have no idea what this novel is all about, but I'm really excited because the game made me excited. And if anyone else has seen the gameplay, you have this big staff that you just attack people with, and that staff can even grow longer apparently, because you have a horde of people standing right in front of you ready to kill you. And that's a lot of people, and I have no idea how you can keep your staff in the back, because it's way too big. Is it like a stretchable staff where you like close it in like boop, 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 and then keep it in the back? I think that's what's gonna happen. You can change from a human-sized person to a beast, you can fight against boss battles, the boss battle looks incredible, and overall it looks so much chaotic and so much fun. It kind of reminds me of Sekiro a lot. I cannot wait to play this game whenever it comes out, because as of right now we don't know when it's gonna come out, because it still is a work in progress, but I hope it does come out like late 2021, maybe 2022. What do you think about this very game? Let me know in the comments below. there are always some games that people want to play again or maybe play a new game of. And most of those games are from Ubisoft. And one of those games that people have been rumoring about a lot more is Prince of Persia. An online retailer from Guatemala called Max, not that clothing brand Max, they have listed a new Prince of Persia remake which is coming on Nintendo as well as PS4, and they have listed it out with a release date of November 2020. That's very soon. Also, apparently Max is the official Nintendo distributor of that country. That is what the people have said who live there, so which means this rumor being true is actually very much possible. Not only that, Jason Schreier also tweeted about it saying that video game retailers love to leak Ubisoft's surprise plans. That's a good play, Ubisoft, but what happened to PC players, man? Well, in the end, it's just a rumor, so we cannot say whether it's true or not. Because we have been having Prince of Persia Remaster or a new Prince of Persia game for a long, long time. We also saw a leaked footage of Prince of Persia cancelled game, which is cancelled, so it doesn't have any point now. And we actually have a new Prince of Persia game coming, but it's a VR game, which is definitely what we wanted. Before this, we have seen Prince in For Honor, who is our enemy, which is again what we wanted. But it's been such a long time since we've seen a good Prince of Persia game. The last game I remember was Prince of Persia Forgotten Sands. It was not that good as Two Thrones or Warrior Within, but it was still a good Prince of Persia game. What do you guys think? Are we getting a remake, a remaster, or we are getting nothing at all? I will probably go with the third option because I don't have much hopes. What do you guys think? Last weekend, we got to see DC Fandom, which is like Comic-Con for DC, where we got to see the Batman trailer. Robert, my god, he looks fantastic in here.
I'm vengeance.
We also got to see trailer of Justice League's Snyder Cut. It looks like we are seeing a totally different movie next year. And we got to see a lot more trailers and reveal. But it was not only down to movies or TV shows, it was also video games, and we got to see two of them. First one is Batman Gotham Knights, where Batman is dead. So why is it called Batman then? Or maybe that's what they want you to believe. The game has four heroes that Batman, of course, took in as a team to fight for Gotham. The game will only be a two-player co-op, where you will play the whole story for the first time without Batman. There are four heroes that you can play as. Batgirl. She's very similar to that of Batman, just in case you didn't know. And she's the daughter of the late Commissioner Gordon. Nightwing, aka the first Robin. We got to play this dude in Batman Arkham Knight. Robin, aka the new one, or Tim Drake. Now this guy is skilled in a variety of stealth techniques and much more. Then we have Red Hood, who is formerly known as Jason Todd, who is an intense and volatile anti-hero and who also has trouble keeping his temper in check. That's definitely not going to be a problem in this game. So I guess basing on how the storyline is going to be, we will get two different heroes that you can select to. The game is not made by Rocksteady, who made the Arkham games. So that means that this game is not a sequel of any of the Arkham games. So it can be possible that there is a different universe or it's a different time, because DC has been expanding on a universe that they also even mentioned in the DC Fandom. The gameplay doesn't look bad. The combos that Batgirl or Nightwing had were really good to look at, and I hope we get to see more. The game will probably have a semi-open world just like Avengers, and speaking of Avengers, I believe that this game is actually looking much better than Avengers. Again, my opinion only. The game has some kind of RPG leveling system added to it, like Assassin's Creed, and it will also have boss battle, because we got to see boss battle between Mr. Freeze and Batgirl, which was fun. And to be honest, when I see Batgirl's face, it reminded me of Batman from Tall Tale Games. Don't they look same? Second game we got to see was Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League. Here you get to play either of the four villains who team up to be a Suicide Squad. We got Harley Quinn, King Shark, Deathshot, and Captain Boomerang. And they will be targeting Superman and maybe some other Justice League members.
So, figure out who we're killing yet?
Oh. It will be a four-player co-op game where if you want, you can play alone with three other bots as your team, or you can, well, invite your friends and play the whole game. We only got to see the cinematic trailer of it, which looks really good, but we cannot judge the game by that, and we haven't seen a gameplay yet. So I hope that the game looks good, because the game has a long time to go as it's coming out on 2022. I'm really happy that DC Fandom went out pretty well. I'm so much excited for a lot of things around movies, games, and TV shows. Really excited to see how the Justice League Snyder Cut is gonna be, and the Batman movie as well. And I'm really looking forward to both the games of DC, Batman Gotham Knights, as well as Suicide Squad. What do you think about these two games, and how are you handling about the death of Batman? Let me know all of that in the comments below. Hitman 3 is the next upcoming game of Hitman where IO Interactive for the first time ever included a number 3 in a Hitman game name. Hitman 3 is coming out in 2021 and it's going to be an exclusive to Epic Store. That's right, that happened because there's a partnership between IO Interactive and Epic Games. Recently, they also revealed a new trailer of some kind where they showed Thornbridge Manor in Dartmoor, England, the first Agent 47's new assassination sandbox, or location in normal terms. Hitman 3 will also be the first game that will be self-published by IO Interactive themselves. Earlier, it was owned by Square Enix, which they then departed from in 2017, and then Hitman 2 was published by Warner Brothers Interactive Entertainment. And now they're self-publishing their own game, which is absolutely amazing. Despite Hitman 3's new contract with Epic Games, Hitman 2 progress, all of it from Steam, will be carried on to Hitman 3, which is amazing. And speaking of Hitman and Epic, Hitman 2016 is coming free on Epic Store from August 27th to November 3rd. So if you claim it between those days, you will keep it forever. And if you want to check out this new reboot that they did to Hitman, now is the time. And definitely I'm buying it because I haven't played that game yet. Thank you everybody for watching this new episode of Top Gaming News. Hope you guys liked it, enjoyed it. If you haven't commented down below, do comment down below what you think about this very episode. And also, to get to know more about game news, tournaments and so much more, subscribe to Gamer Connect right now and also hit that notification bell icon so that you don't miss a thing. My name is Gavin Manis and I'll check you guys out in the next video. Bye bye.